Hi, Professor. How are you?
Very good. Are you excited about Lecture 6?
I am. And I am glad that I caught you before class.
Great. What is going on?
I am just getting excited to get started with my project. When can we start writing surveys and interviewing people?
The time is coming soon. Lecture 6 is actually going to focus on data collection, so the timing is perfect. We will take 2 weeks to cover this important topic, and by the end you will hopefully be ready to start collecting some data about the issue you are investigating for the project.
Great. My boss will be happy. She is afraid to do anything until we know more about the issue and what options are available.
That is actually good news. As they say, it is important to know the target before you pull the trigger. So we will focus on transitioning the frameworks and questions we have been developing into practical data collection plans in the coming days. These will then ensure that we collect only the information that will be useful for guiding decisions.
Do all needs assessments use surveys?
No. No single data collection method is used in all assessments. Rather, we select the appropriate methods based on the context. Sometimes you already have lots of information on the perspectives of those who are involved with the issue. This may be from previous surveys or other reports. While at other times a survey fits into the plan well since you don't have the information you require from a spread out group of people.
So I should keep my options open?
Yes, don't commit to any methods until you first know what information you have to collect. You may have most everything already available from other projects. If you do have to collect new information, then you will want to choose the method for collecting the data based on what makes the most sense within the context. For example, you may want to interview key decision makers, and have focus groups with small groups of people who are affected by the issue. Many times, these techniques are more flexible and useful for answering questions.
Okay, I will not decide on any method quite yet.
When you have a good idea of what information you require, who has that information, where they are and how much time they have available, then you can start to decide which methods will work best. Once you decide on the method, then you can work on the types of questions that will best get you the information you require.
Are there options?
Oh yes. You can obviously ask direct questions. For instance, how many times a week do you fill out this form? Or you can ask critical incident questions, such as tell me about a time in the last month when you had problems filling out this form. Or you can ask people to put a number to their experience. For example, on a scale of 1 to 5, how hard is this form to fill out? And there are other ways to ask questions. What is important is that you get the information that you require and that the information is as accurate as possible.
So it gets a little complicated.
It can, but it does not have to be complicated. Just stay focused on the information you require to guide decisions. And test the questions out before you use them. Ask a classmate, friend, or colleague to answer the questions and see what they tell you. If it is useful, then you are on the right track. But if they struggle to remember the information or have problems answering the question in a way that is useful to you, then you should revise it.
Thank you. This is going to be fun. And if it takes another week or two to get it right, then I'm sure that my boss will be fine with it.
That is good. My experience is that it is better to get it right the first time rather than going back to people to ask questions again.
Okay, Professor. Thanks for the help and I will see you online.
Bye, Liz. Just let me know if you have questions.